the game can see the boxing voice. All right, Aaron Cantu, the boxing voice here with Razvan Kajanu. How do you say your name? Thank you, man. Cool. All right, man. How does it feel to be fighting in the state of California and Los Angeles?
Man, it feels great, and especially I'm fighting in Staples Center. It's one of the most amazing places from California. I mean, what can be better than the Staples Center? It's a question. Tell me. Nothing. Nothing. I mean, Staples is the biggest and the most famous place to perform, right?
Razvan, talk about what you do well in the ring. In your own words, what are some of your strengths? What are some of your best attributes in the boxing ring?
I mean, you can see my height, right? That's a big advantage. I mean, I'm going to use my my reach and my strength, my power. I mean, I'm a big guy.
Definitely, man. Every boxer has something to work on. What are some of the things you focus on improving in your game?
I mean, for a southpaw, it's everything is opus. You have to do it opus, you know, and you have to train properly for a southpaw. And I had a game plan made with my coach and my team, and everything is came great. I mean, I'm looking forward for Saturday night to show it to everyone. And it's my best shot because it's on the one of the biggest TV station from the world, Showtime. I mean, what can be better than this?
All right, man. Now, you're going in, you're fighting one of the boogeyman of the division, Luis Ortiz. Talk about this fight, man. Talk about how you ended up taking this fight and what is the, you know, what do you plan on showing the world on Saturday?
I mean, we got the question, we got the call. And we need 1 second and we say yes. I mean, this is one of my dreams, to fight what is in the world boxing right now, the best. Luis Ortiz is one of the, you guys say it, is one of the most avoided heavyweight from the box right now at this point. And my point is to fight who's the best.
Definitely, man. And we saw you in a fight against the world champion, Joseph Parker. What did you learn from that fight against Joseph Parker? And what did you, you know, focus on in training camp?
I learned from that fight my main important thing. I always have to stay in a decent and good shape. When you get a call, to do it and to do it right. I was out of shape for that fight. But now it's a total different game ball. I mean, I'm different now. This fight catch me in a good shape. I mean, we just had to adjust and make the game plan for this fight. That's it.
Cool, man. Now, you're a heavyweight, so I got to get your expert take on a couple of the things happening in the heavyweight division. What's your take on the fight between Anthony Joshua and Alexander Povetkin?
That's a tough fight. I know Povetkin very well because I've been in his camp. And it's a tough fight. It's in England. I mean, Povetkin is a great fighter. Joshua, it's a champion, it's a great champion. I mean, this is an interesting fight. You ask me who I'm thinking we're going to win the fight? Joshua. It's more younger, he got more tools. I don't think Povetkin is going to put him in trouble.
If you had to give Povetkin any advice, what would you tell him going into the fight? What specifically does he have to do?
To copy Tyson's style. Move side to side and be active and try to get close as much as possible and punch hard, very hard, to the body.
All right, man. And there's obviously a big fight brewing if Joshua wins and if Wilder stays undefeated. What's your take on a Deontay Wilder versus Anthony Joshua fight?
That's a tough fight. I'm stick with the USA. Always. I mean, Wilder got a pretty great right hand. And I mean, his jab, it's a great fight. But that's a match which should be huge. I don't know where, probably something in Vegas, but that should be the match, from the biggest match from the earth. Bigger than Mayweather.
Thanks, Razvan. Good luck, man.
the game, cause see the boxing boys.